So hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Dhruv here from Plus Drive. Hope you guys are doing great. And today in this video, we are going to talk about this luxury looking sedan, which is the Volkswagen Vento, the 2019 variant. And also guys, before starting the video, I would like to remind you, please consider subscribing to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any amazing content in the future over here. And also follow me on Instagram, because I too post stuff on my Instagram handle. The links will be mentioned below. So with that said guys, let us just start with the video. So this over here, this is the Volkswagen Vento 1.2 liter TSI Highline Plus automatic variant. So this is a 5-seater luxury sedan. And also this car is competing with Maruti Suzuki Ciaz, Honda City, Toyota Yaris and Skoda Rapid, which is the sibling of this car only, the Volkswagen. So the Volkswagen Vento is available in three variants, which is Comfort Line, Highline and Highline Plus. So the Highline Plus is the top of the line variant in its lineup, which is this. And this Vento Highline Plus is 1.2 liter TSI petrol, which is priced at 12.25 lakh ex showroom Delhi. So those were some specification of the car. Now coming to the engine part, which is the main thing, it has 1.2 liter 4 cylinder TSI turbocharged petrol engine, which creates 103 bhp at 5000 rpm and 175 nm of torque at 1500 rpm to 4100 rpm. So that is pretty fast. And it has 7 speed dual clutch automatic transmission, which is 0 to 100 in 12.3 seconds. That is pretty fast. So this is the insulation over here for decreasing of the engine noise in the cabin when you go on the high speed and all. So that will decrease your noise, and engine is well and neatly arranged, the components if you look. So this was about the engine. So now coming to the design and exterior of the vehicle. So over here you have this massive chrome garnish grill over here, which gives the car very unique and very nice premium look over here. Makes the car bend towards the luxury side. Then the Volkswagen logo in between. Then these are the LED headlamps with DRLs, and also Corning headlight feature available over here. So a very nice LED headlamp with DRLs in the lower side, and also turn indicators over there. Then these are the your conventional fog lamps over here. So this is a towing hook. These are not LED fog lamps available in this car. And also you have this chrome garnish treatment available over here. As I told you, it gives the car look very premium. So a lot of chrome treatment in this car, which makes the car stand towards the luxury side. This is a premium sedan. So over here, these are the conventional fog lamps, and also this chrome treatment done over here, starting from the left fog lamp all the way going to the right side fog lamp. So it gives a very nice floating chrome garnish grills on the top as well as on the bottom side. Then coming over here, these are the electronically adjustable ORVMs with turn indicators available over there. So these are electronically adjustable in dual tone, like in the candy white color and also the black tone color on the lower side. So coming to the handlebars, you get a chrome treatment over here also. So not a lot of changes as you compare to the previous variant, only some cosmetic changes and the petrol engine changes. So over here also you get a chrome garnish treatment, and also on the lower side where you get a body cladding, you get in a chrome cladding over here, which gives a very nice premium look to the car. And so this is the chrome treatment done over here all the way from the front, it is going to the rear. So very nice treatment done over here. So now coming to the tire and suspension, you get 195/55 R16 inch alloy wheels with lot of spokes, and in front you get a MacPherson strut suspension, and in the rear you get semi independent trailing arm suspension system. So which gives the ride quality very soft and very comfortable ride quality. Now talking about the dimensions of the car. So the length of the car is 4390 mm, the width is 1699 mm, the height is 1467 mm, the wheelbase of the car is 2553 mm, the if you talk about the curb width of the car, that is 1179 kilograms, and the gross weight of the vehicle is 1720 kg. So those were the dimension of the car. And also in the front you get a ventilated disc brakes, and in the rear you get a drum brakes. So now coming to the rear part of the vehicle, you get an integrated spoiler, and these are the conventional tail lamps with also LED inserted over there. And also you get a chrome garnish treatment in the rear also, from the left tail lamp all the way to the right tail lamps. And this is the Volkswagen logo in between. Then you have on the left side you have the Vento badging, and on the right side you have the TSI badging, which is the variant in the Volkswagen Vento and Highline Plus. Then the even the you can manually open the boot over here. So you get an integrated spoiler over here, which gives a very nice aerodynamics to the car. It will be very good for the safety purpose also. Then over here you get the rear defoggers, and you get a normal regular antenna, not the shark fin antenna in this car. So overall this was the rear of the car, the nice chrome treatment done over there, which gives the car very, you know, stand towards the premium side and the luxury side. Then you get the four parking sensors over here at the rear, which you can call even the four NOS at the rear, and also in the front you get. So over here lot of chrome treatment done in the rear part. Even on the lower side you get reflectors over here, and also chrome garnish treatment done over here in the lower bumper also. So as I told you guys, I won't repeat again and again, you get lot of chrome treatments in this variant, in the 2019 variant, and also some cosmetic changes more towards the headlamp, then also the tail lamps and all. So this is a fuel lid over here. Under that you have the 55 liters of tank, which gives the ARI mileage is 18 kilometers per liter. Then this is the B pillar is in the piano finish, you can say. And also the top speed for the car is 185 kilometers per hour. I was talking of regarding the fuel tank I was talking about. So these are the interiors over here. So you get an integrated legroom light over here. You don't have to go for the aftermarket, you get a stock over here. So this is the door trim over here. Now we are talking about the interiors. So this is the lock and unlock button, and the ORVM controls over here, and some window controls also available over here. It is in dune tone, and the quality is very nice. It is in beige and black. You get a bottle holder, and this is a sound system over here. Then this is the boot lid opening button over here, and also you get a keyless entry for the boot lid. Then this is the bottle holder over here. So a very nice door trim with unique design over here, very curvy design if you can say. Then this is the how the interior looks over here. So these are some controls for the headlamps. Then these are the AC vents, and you get a nice aluminium brush treatment done over there. So here I am inside the vehicle. I must say this car is pretty, I mean very much improved as you compare to the previous variant. Over here you get a nice leather wrapped steering wheel with flat bottom. Yes guys, you get the steering wheel with flat bottom, not the whole thing in round. So this is the flat bottom over here, and the middle part is in black piano finish. Then a lot of chrome treatment done on this vehicle, which is very astonishing. Over here in between you have the Volkswagen logo, and also some controls over here. On the left side you have infotainment controls, and on the right side voice commands, and also you get a cruise control over here available with nice quality of switches and buttons. Not cheap, not towards the cheap side. Then this is the dashboard over here, which feels very, you know, spacious and very airy with nice quality of this thing plastic. Then this is the glove box over here with cool glove box. You can literally put a laptop in here, that's how big it is. So as this is a Volkswagen Vento, I mean this is a Volkswagen car, the plastic and everything is top notch. You won't be sad by the quality, what all the features are provided in this car and all. So this is the infotainment screen. This is a touchscreen system which supports Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, auxiliary. Then you have card reader and also USB input. So with the minimal functions available over here, then this is the AC vent over here, the hazard button just below, then the traction control button available over there. So minimal buttons available over here for the clean look, and also some aluminium brush treatment available around the AC vents corners, and also the infotainment screen available over there. Then this is the automatic climate control AC functions available over here with minimal, and also display in the between, which gives a very nice spacious cabin feel. And this is the some storage option in the front you get over there, so you can keep the phone and everything over there. Then over here this is the 7-speed dual clutch automatic transmission with 7-speed DSG. So the transmission and everything, the gear switch and all, will be pretty fast. as this is a 7-speed DSG, best in segment. Then some storage space under the gear, the handbrake also. Then this is the, what you can say, the armrest, very soft cushioned armrest. Under that you have some storage to keep your phone or the car key available. You can keep it over there. Then these are the soft cushioned seat with a nice lumbar support and a very nice under thigh support also available over there. As I'm sitting over here, the seat is very comfortable and a nice headroom, nice legroom. This is how the cabin feels. Very roomy, very spacious. Not a lot of changes, but some changes regarding the chromes and everything is done over here. Then this is the instrument cluster over here, not digital. You get a TFT display in the between for vehicle settings and all. You can know it over there. And the speedometer and tachometer are in you can say analog, not the digital. The steering wheel is telescopic. You can go for the reach and even as well as the rake, so which is a very nice add-on feature over here, which is a very good part in this segment. I mean, you don't get in Rapid or in Sierra's the telescopic steering wheel. So this was about the interior in the front cabin. Then over here you get a toll receipt holder, no vanity mirror or the lights. Then on the left side you get a vanity mirror with no lights. Then these are the cabin lights over here. I don't know what is wrong with the battery or something wrong. Then also you get an auto dimming rear view mirror, no manually, so that is an add-on feature. So this is how the cabin is from the front side. I'll show you the rear cabin as well. So let us now jump to the rear cabin and see what the car has to provide us on the rear side. But before that, if I talk about some safety features of this car, so in this particular variant you get anti-lock braking system, child safety locks, day and night rear view mirror, door ajar warning, front impact beam with crash sensors, vehicle stability control system, speed sensing auto door lock, ISOFIX child seat mounts, hill descent control, hill assist, anti-theft device, automatic headlamp, centrally mounted fuel tank, engine immobilizer, passenger airbag, and last, equipped with DSG, which makes the car shift its gears very fast as you compare to the current segments. So those were some safety features of the car. Now let us get inside and see what the car has to offer us on the rear cabin. So this is the same door trim with dual tone. You get a polished chrome aluminium handlebar and also bottle storage over here and some speaker system available. So black and beige, same color combination available at the rear also. So this is how the rear cabin is. I mean, very nice legroom, nice under thigh support and a nice headroom. You get a door window seat pockets at the rear. So this is the knee room available, nice large knee room. I'm 5'8", so I'm quite comfortable. Then the AC vent for the rear passenger as well, and you get an ashtray over here and also a 12V charging socket for the rear passenger as well. So this is how the rear seats are. You don't get a headrest for the middle passenger, but you do get a, what you called, armrest over here. This is packed, I cannot show you right now. And also that you get a two twin cup holders. So three people can easily sit over here with nice under thigh support and a nice legroom, quite comfortable. Seat pockets at the rear also. So this is the height adjustable seat belts. You get a grab handle over here and a coat hook over here on both the side, and as well as on the B pillar you get a coat hook over here, which is a nice add-on feature, I mean, in this segment, which will be also a first in segment. So you also get a rear reading lights over here in the rear cabin on both the side. So I don't know why was the front cabin lights not working, but the rear is working. So this is how the rear cabin feels. Very spacious and comfortable, nice to a very good for the comfortable rides for the long distance as well as for daily use as well. So nice, what you can say, a driver's car and as well as the passenger car. So lot of things available over here. Now let us talk about the boot, what the boot is offering us in this car, how much boot space we get. So you get a keyless entry as well as also the boot opening button available over there. Then this is the HD camera available over here with adaptive guidelines. You get a rear view camera. Then over here, this is the 494 liters of boot space available over here. That is massive in its segment when you compare to other cars in this segment. So under there, so over here you have the, you don't get the light. I mean, the, yeah, you get the light on the top as well over here. for a better visibility in the night. Then under over here, you don't get a full size spare wheel, you get a steel spare wheel, that too in 14 inch. Yes, that is a cost cutting over here. Then the toolkit available over here, and some storage space to keep your what fluids and all you can keep over here at the back. So nice neatly arranged boot over here. Then lot of space, which is 494 liter. That is massive and huge. And also guys, I would like to remind you, you get 5 interesting color options in this, which is candy white, which is this one. You get reflex silver, carbon steel, toffee brown, and the last, which is titanium beige. So these were the interesting color options available over here. So that was about the exterior, interior, engine specs, safety specification I've told you about. And also I've told you about the pricing of the car, which is 12.25 lakh ex showroom Delhi. So I hope I have provided you all the information regarding the 2019 Volkswagen Vento. And also guys, with that said, I end my video over here. So what do you feel about the car? Give your thoughts about it in the comment section below. And also subscribe to my channel, consider subscribing and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any amazing content. And also follow me on Instagram, the links will be mentioned below, and as well as on the Twitter. So thank you guys for tuning in. See you next time for another video. Take care.